Now at 5, the first day of remote learning for Miami-Dade County schools did not get off to the start teachers, parents, and students had hoped for.
There's nothing like the reopening of schools to bring normalcy and stability to communities. We're doing it in a reasonable and reasoned way, a protective way.
And to tell you about a big decision right now regarding reopening schools in Miami-Dade County.
The school board has voted to start in-person learning next week.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Jose Marti MAST, 6-12 Academy, where learning means more doing. Also, welcome to the cleanest and safest school in the universe.
What is your favorite memory of this school year?
My friends.
My favorite part of the year was coming back to school physically because that meant that I could hang out with my friends and see them like in person, which was something that I was looking forward to.
I don't know, maybe like around the beginning of the school year when I like officially like came back to school for the first time, all my family meeting people.
My favorite memory was probably around December where I had a Secret Santa like event with my friends in PE, and we all had a lot of fun there.
Hanging out with all my friends.
Oh, my favorite memory of the school year was like the day we came back from online from MSO to like physical, and I got to see everyone after like 6 months of not seeing anyone. So that was pretty cool. That's my favorite memory.
In general, how did you feel about this school year?
It was pretty weird because, you know, quarantine and all that, and it was hard to, you know, communicate with some teachers.
The hardest part of the school year was probably trying to focus in my Zoom classes because, like, you know, the teacher's not actually there, so it's hard to stay focused.
Probably the hardest part might be state testing. Not because the questions were hard, it just got boring. And it was overwhelming, the whole setup.
The hardest part for me this year was probably towards the end of the year, where we had to take all these final exams, and it just like really stresses you out, like entirely. So, yeah. And then like after we take the exams, it's just like so like refreshing and stuff, and you feel amazing.
What was the hardest part for you as a teacher this year?
That's a good question. Trying to balance everything. Because I feel like everyone's gonna say that, but there's something just different about online. Because I just, you know, I feel bad for the kids who couldn't be here, and then I've been told by other students that they prefer to be in school than online. So I would definitely say it's gonna be trying to teach online, trying to keep those kids engaged, trying to keep them entertained even, and then making sure that they're on task.
What are your plans for this summer?
Mostly to just work out a lot and like better myself and hang out with friends a lot. And I'm also going to Dominican Republic with family and friends.
Well, this summer I'm going out with my cousin on vacation.
To the beach. I'm planning on doing like a lot of reading. Probably I want to like get better on that and just go out with my family and just hang out with them, like just make sure that I'm having fun.
This summer I plan on practicing my math because I'm not too good on it, and probably hanging out with my cousins.
We're here with Adrian. Adrian, what are you gonna do over the summer?
Hang out with my friends and watch movies with them.
Perfect. Thank you. For a dollar, what are you going to do over the summer?
Nothing.
Thank you. We're here with Mr. Rodriguez. What are you planning on doing for the summer?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Best summer ever.
Thank you, Mr.
All right.
What are you looking forward for the next year?
For the next year, I'm really looking forward for everyone to come back, basically. And so we can get back a sense of like normalcy.
that we didn't have this year.
I'm looking forward to taking off my mask post-COVID crisis and a new improvement on the school.
Everyone coming back. Yes. It's just everyone coming back and we'll be able to be here. Being able to teach some of the kids I had in sixth grade again next year, that's what I'm looking forward to. And being able to be reunited with some kids I had who were in eighth grade, they're gonna be in my AP class next year. It's just basically everyone coming back.
I think being able to finally do labs again, like being able to dissect things, being able to actually interact with each other, doing things like that is what I'm looking forward to next year.
Welcome to Nightline for Wednesday, October 21st, 2020. I'm Ren Daniel and we are back. We hope to be your morning companion each school day for the 2020-2021 school year. Make sure you check with us to get the latest news about school happenings and announcements.
Welcome to Nightline for Thursday, October 22nd, 2020. I am Christopher Franco with school news and announcements for Jose Marti MAST 6-12 Academy.
Welcome to Nightline for Monday, November 2nd, 2020. I am Danny Marina Brito with school news and announcements for Jose Marti MAST 6-12 Academy.
Welcome to Nightline for Friday, November 6, 2020. I am Hannah with school news and announcements for Jose Marti MAST 6-12 Academy. We'll begin with our local weather report.
I'm Nicole with your Nightline weather.
I'm Christopher Perez with your Nightline weather.
I'm Camila Marti with your Nightline weather.
I'm Hansel Segura with your Nightline weather.
I'm Indira with your Nightline weather.
And the Weather Channel was reporting that Hurricane Iota is spreading a dangerous threat of flooding, rainfall, and damaging winds into Central America.
I'm Gabriel Lodi with your Nightline weather.
I am Alex Cantor with your Nightline weather.
Ever wonder what's going on in the world? Here is Mario with today's Planet Report.
I am Mario Dominguez with Planet Report. CNN is reporting that Iceland's Prime Minister was interrupted by an earthquake while filming an interview on Tuesday.
I'm Natalie Figueroa with Planet Report. CNN is reporting that at least 79 people have died from a powerful earthquake that hit the Aegean Sea on Friday in Turkey.
I am Emily Campos with Planet Report. Reuters is reporting that around 125 people were missing in northern India after a Himalayan glacier broke and swept away a small hydroelectric dam on Sunday.
I am Gabriel for Planet Report. CNN is reporting that China has successfully landed a lunar probe on a previously unexplored area of the moon.
Erica Prendes with Planet Report. The local .es is reporting that Spain has recorded its coldest temperature ever, negative 34.1 degrees Celsius.
On October 22nd, 2020, there was a mass distribution throughout the school. Thankfully, Mr. Enriquez was kind enough to answer some of these questions for us. Our first question is, why did you decide to distribute these masks?
Student masks were recently distributed to all students. The masks were distributed to provide students with multiple choices in which masks to wear.
Thank you, Mr. Enriquez. These were just a few questions about the recent mass distribution, and I hope this interview was able to answer some of your questions regarding the recent mass distribution.
Hi, my name's Nicholas. Even though a traditional Halloween might not be possible this year, there's still some things you can do to celebrate. At the Dolphin Mall, you can pick up a goodie bag filled with candy, chocolate, and more until 7 p.m.
Welcome to the Miami-Dade County Public Schools 2020 Mock Presidential Election. As a student at Jose Marti MAST 6-12 Academy, you'll be participating in the election in the precinct 7291. Today, you will cast your vote for president and Miami-Dade County mayor.
And before we go, while the presidential election has yet to be settled nationally, the results are in the MDCPS Mock Election Student Vote. The Department of Social Sciences is reporting that former Vice President Joe Biden took 17,572 votes from students countywide to 9,525 votes for Donald Trump. That's a 64-35 ratio. Florida Division of Elections reports that in Miami-Dade County, the vote was 532,460 for Donald Trump, or 46% of the vote, to 617,289, or 53% for Joe Biden. Statewide, President Trump received 5,659,590 votes, or 51%, to 5,286,114, or 48% of the vote. Thank you to all students who participated in the MTCPS mock election.
Introducing The Earth Actually Matters with Isa Rodriguez. Scientists predict that by 2100, Greenland will be shedding ice faster than any time in the past 12,000 years. Scientists report on October 1st in Nature.
Hello everyone, I am Mario Dominguez with Nightline SciTech. It's a section where we talk about anything related with science and or technology. Let's get into it.
This year, Thanksgiving has taken on a different meaning. From honoring our healthcare workers to admiring our educators who have flawlessly performed their jobs throughout this pandemic, we have begun to take notice of the little things of life.
So this year, I'm thankful for my family getting together. It's like the first time we've gotten all together for Thanksgiving. I'm really thankful for that.
This year, I'm thankful for my family, my friends, and my food.
This year, I'm very thankful for being admitted to school as I love this place. I love how everyone is so nice and there's so much in the school that you can do. And I just love the school.
Joining us on the show today is Dr. William Sawyer. Dr. Sawyer is a physician from Cincinnati, Ohio. He holds a degree from the University of Cincinnati College of Medicine and has been interviewed on radio and television around the country and in the Philadelphia Inquirer and the New York Times. He's also the founder of the Henry Lehan Foundation. Dr. Sawyer, thank you for joining us today.
Great. Happy to be here. Thank you.
Thank you. We discovered that the National Hand Washing Awareness Campaign, which runs through December 6th through the 12th, you describe your focus on primary infection prevention.
On December 15th, 1791, the First Amendments to the Constitution were ratified. Ever since December 15th has been known as the Bill of Rights Day, the national celebration of the Bill of Rights.
Hour of Code is a global movement that happens every year throughout the Computer Science Education Week. This year, Computer Science Education Week will be from December 7th to the 13th.
Hour of Code is dedicated to introduce millions of students each year to computer science and inspire them to learn more about important technology skills.
I believe the Hour of Code, which many of our teachers participated in, was a great idea and great tool to focus our teachers, particularly our non-science teachers, to the area of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
Well, computer science we apply in all of our classes. In every single level, I use some type of application.
The Hour of Code is a great opportunity for students to collaborate and learn from one another. It challenges them to open their horizons to something that might have been forgotten prior to this experience.
Welcome to the Jose Marti MAST TV production winter special. We've got a great show for you today.
So this is another World War I story. So it's December, it's Christmas Eve, 1914. The war's been going on for about 5 months. Everyone thought the war would be over by now, and they thought they'd be home by Christmas. Turns out that wasn't the case. And what you have now is trench lines from all the way from the English Channel down to the borders of Switzerland. And, you know, everyone's fighting, people have been dying. And on this particular night, you have the British on one side and the Germans on the other side.
COVID has been rough on everybody this year. But Santa? Oh, he's taking it harder than everybody else.
Let's continue to get into the festive mood with another musical number. Here's Aaron Chand.
Joining us on the show today is Dr. Alexandra Cornelius. She is the director of the Center for Women's and Gender Studies and a senior instructor in history and African diaspora studies at FIU. I wanted to get her perspective on Martin Luther King Jr.
Okay. MLK is best known in the public imagination for his I Have a Dream speech and his letter from Birmingham Jail. Can you tell us a bit about those themes woven through
Sure. So the I Have a Dream speech speech, of course, is known as the iconic speech that kind of captured the public imagination of African Americans who were striving for basic rights, basic recognition of civil rights.
My favorite disc jockeys and DJs, by definition, are people who record music to play it on radios or even at a disco. But now, these days, you can find your favorite DJs on any streaming platform and on the internet.
The type of music that I put on my playlist is trap and reggaeton because of its great style and rhythm. And a DJ I know is Alex Sensation. And I love the way he mixes, especially when he transitions from one song to the other, but still makes it feel like it's just one song.
Hey guys, my name is Indira Singh, and welcome to our new Be Smart, Be Hip, Be Healthy segment, where we share with you our hip tips on how to stay safe and healthy.
Welcome to our Nightline Valentine's Day special. Our Jose Marti MAST TV production classes have created presentations to entertain and inform you this Valentine's Day. We have also partnered with Ms. Galette and the drama class. They perform the poetry readings.
I am always there. You're never alone. By Ashley Becker. When you're feeling down and blue, and life is being cruel to you, just remember, you're not on your own. I'm always there. You're never alone.
Friendship by Miss Scorpio. You are my best friend. You belong in my heart. We go through ups and downs, but still nothing can tear us apart. I know you as a sister, and I will always care. Love, respect, and trust are the things we share. I know you as a person. I especially know you as a friend. Our friendship is something that will never end.
Valentine's Day can be hard on some people until you find that special someone.
To cover the headlines of the week and more depth.
One of the best times to visit Thailand is during the celebration of the Songkran Festival. The Songkran Festival, also known as the traditional Thai New Year, is usually celebrated in mid-April.
April 17th is National Haiku Day. The haiku first emerged in Japanese literature during the 17th century as a terse reaction to elaborate poetic traditions.
It's glowing blue. There must be a message in this MD unit.
TV production, for many years you've served our school in the Magnet Wars. Now we need your help again. May the 4th is upon us, and our status as a math and science school is in jeopardy if we don't produce a Star Wars themed show. We are occupied with AP testing, and I am concerned that this important mission will fail. Get this droid's message safely to our students in time for AP testing. Our students will know how to retrieve it. This is our most desperate hour. You must help us, TV production. You're our only hope.
I guess we have our mission.
Welcome to Nightline for Tuesday, May 4th, 2021.
Welcome to Nightline for Monday, June 7th, 2021. I'm Alex Anton with the school news and announcements for Jose Marti MAST 612 Academy. Welcome to the last days of school of the 2020 through 2021 school year. The bell schedule for the next couple of days will be a bit different. First block will run through 8:20. Second block will run from 8:28 through 9:28. This past Friday, the class of 2021 ended their Jose Marti MAST journey as they walked across the stage at the Ocean Bank Convocation Center at FIU. If you missed the graduation ceremony, you can find it on our district's video platform, linked in the video description. Congratulations again to the senior class.
Welcome to Nightline for Wednesday, June 9th, 2021. I'm Maxwell Scaglione with School News and Announcements for Jose Marti MAST 6 through 12 Academy, and the last edition of Nightline News for the 2020-2021 school year.
And that's it to us today. I'm Alex Canton.
And I'm Maxwell Scaglione.
We will see you the next school year. Have a great summer.